Working on a weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual. Niggas swear they passed us, they doing too much. Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts. Niggas caught me slipping once, okay, so what? Someone hit your block up, I tell you if it was us.
We are coming live from Home Depot once again, y'all. But it's going to be a quick run. I just got to go and get some liquid nail. Liquid nail is that stuff I've been putting on the back of the wood. Then I place on the wall so the wood can stay on the wall. And I also got to return these screws right here, y'all. So come to find out, I didn't need these screws. These motherfuckers cost $10. And I will be getting my money back because I am cheap and I am smart at the same time. My money, you dig? Honestly, I should get that big ass tube, y'all. But you know your brother cheap. Beginning this one right here, $21. Y'all see that? Boom. And let's see. Let's make sure. Ooh, there it goes. We should be all good. Since we ain't here, y'all, I might as well get some carpet, you dig? I'm getting the cheapest carpet possible because carpet's expensive. For instance, y'all, this costs $5 per square foot, right? And how much I need is probably like 160 square feet. You do the math. That's too much. So I'm going to find like the cheapest carpet. Probably some thin shit. Super thin. Probably like some stuff like this. This is probably expensive too. But something like this. Something like this color. Probably like a gray or a dark color because I don't like to vacuum a lot. And I think the one I want costs like 85 cents per square foot. So that should be cool. That should be like a smooth, probably like 150 or something. Just priced a few things. So yeah, the carpet still costs like a smooth 150, but I'm not at that level yet, y'all. So I'm thinking the downstairs basement, the color I'm gonna paint is gonna be like a sunburnt orange. And I think that's gonna be really dope. Things gonna stand out hella good, you know what I mean? Cause I was about to get like a gray or a beige, but that shit's boring. So about to get something that can stand out. Exactly, $25. Coffee time. Y'all know I always get the cheap coffee, but I always come here and act like I'm looking at this. No, I'm really not. Look at the price of this stuff, y'all. Look at that. $4. I spent $1.95. New packages, 1 second. You're being so close to like a dream or a goal that you just want to keep your eyes closed until you get there. Y'all, I've been going through this like throughout my whole life. It's like every time I get real close to a goal or a dream or a vision or whatever, I always try to like keep my eyes closed until I get there. I don't know why. It feels like I'm so happy I booked that trip to Europe. Now I need to get there. That's like my biggest thing ever. It's like, I love when I'm doing Uber. I'm here talking to people about like, yeah, I booked my flight. It feels amazing. I'm enjoying this feeling. Now I need to get there. This is like the same exact feeling I had last year when I was graduating. Like I was in November. I had just passed one of the biggest tests of my nursing school career. And only thing that was on my mind, like, okay, I passed this test. Now I need to get to graduation. You know what I mean? I tried to enjoy the moment by, you know, vlogging it. But man, it's just something about that, y'all. It's like the closer I'm getting to this trip, the higher my anxiety is getting. And not no like, ooh, anxiety, but you know, like my heart's beating. I'm like, oh my God, this is about to actually happen, y'all. It's just like man, a dream is really manifesting right now through this camera, y'all. Like I told you, a majority of my life, my eyes are closed, you know what I mean? And when I say that, I'm just talking more so from a mental perspective. Like every day, obviously, I know I'm vlogging. I know I just booked a flight to Europe, my fault. I know I'm working on the basement. I know all this stuff and I see it, but my eyes are still closed at the same time because I'm just living the moment, man. You know what I mean? Years ago, I watched this video by Gary Vee. It's titled, Close Your Eyes Until You're 29. And what he's trying to say is pretty much just grind, work, do things you love to do, and don't focus too much on the result. And that's what I've been doing for the last probably about 6 years of my, no, how old am I? 24 years of my life, honestly, y'all. I started living my life to a whole new level when I hit 23 years old, 27. Now I just turned 27 2 months ago. So about, you know, 3.5-4 years ago, y'all, is when I actually started living my life and closing my eyes and opening them every now and then. I know I say that a lot of my vlogs, like I live my life, my eyes closed, but I really do, y'all. Like I know my goal and I know what I want out of life, but as I'm, you know, working towards that goal, working towards that vision, working towards, you know, my dream, I try to keep my eyes closed 90% of the time because I don't want to panic and freak out. And that's what happens sometimes, you dig? But what's good, my family? Just got done with Uber. And you know what? I'm going to start the vlog off with this. Well, end the vlog off with this. So I got these packages in the other day, and I have yet to open them, y'all. You know what I mean? I'm not going to sit here. I've been so busy, but I just haven't really, you know, cared to show y'all these investments. But these are some basic investments I got, y'all. Very basic investments. Ooh. All right. Right here, I have a tripod, a big-ass tripod. I think this tripod is 75 inches tall, y'all. That's pretty damn tall. I think me and this tripod is the same exact height. The reason why I got a tall tripod is because I want a real tripod. I keep on getting those knockoff $18 ones, and they get the job done, man. But I'm going to need a good tripod for Europe, man. So let's see how this tripod looks. Ooh, I probably can't bring this from Europe. Look how big this tripod is, y'all. Damn. This is a big-ass tripod. Hold on, let's see. Let's check it out. Yeah, the Lavish Journey. Oh, my Lord. This look official. Imagine going somewhere with this. Yeah, I'm here to record a video. People be like, God damn, boy. But yeah, I got this tripod because my other one kept breaking. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to need a good tripod for Europe. But it looks like this tripod may be too big for Europe. But I'm still going to keep this, though. I definitely need this for the basement, 100%. But wow. Yeah, this cost, I think this is like $40. This is probably like the second most expensive thing I got, because the webcam cost $49 and this mug cost $40. And my other investment I got, this is a very, very basic simple investment. Hold on. This right here. So for my podcast, right, The Lavish Journey, we actually do the podcast on a table, a regular 6-foot table, right? And I always get like a plastic table cover from Dollar Tree. And you know, that's cool and all, but I want to look a little more professional. So I got a real deal linen tablecloth, y'all. Boom. Like I told y'all, I'm doing everything professional. As y'all saw all my investments, y'all see I'm taking everything I'm doing serious, man, such as traveling, the Lavish Journey, myself, my health. Well, I still kind of eat unhealthy, but everything, man, you know what I mean? Like I told y'all, man, right now, I'm making dreams come true. You know what I mean? I'm trying to keep my eyes closed while embracing the moment at the same time, because at the end of the day, these moments are historical, you dig? But yeah, let's get straight to the fun facts of the day though, y'all. Today was a smooth day. You know, today was actually really good. I know right now it's kind of late, but I got done with Uber super early day at 2 a.m. instead of 5 a.m. and everything went pretty good, you know what I mean? And I met some good people. I actually, you know, every time I bring up my Europe trip, somebody always says they went there and they always give me good feedback on it. So it makes me even more excited to get there, y'all. But like I said, I got to keep my eyes closed and grind even harder. You know, although I booked that plane ticket, I still got to grind like I didn't book that plane ticket, so I can keep that ambition going, keep that money going. That's what, another reason why I keep my eyes closed, to keep that grind going. So I love the grind, man. All right, let's get it. What's today's date? January 21st, 2020. Fun facts. Thought of the day. Snowflakes are one of nature's most fragile things, but just look at what they can do when they stick together. Vesta Kelly. Yeah, that's true. You already know I'm about to agree with this. Yeah, I agree, because, man, for instance, when we all sit together, I'm talking about all of us in a whole wide world, we was to all three sit together and work together, we all be very successful. You know what I mean? Obviously, the whole world is going to be on that page, but it'd be great if, you know, at least 85% of the world can do that. But then again, when you think about it, I find we all do stick together in a way. You know what I mean? For me to find a way to get to Europe, and for me to do all this traveling, do all this stuff y'all see me doing, I had to learn through somebody. So therefore, we kind of do stuff together. It's all about who you surround yourself with, you know what I mean? It's also about the energy you give off. If you give off good energy, people are going to give you good energy back. Like I posted a tweet the other day saying, you know, I've met a lot of dope people because I'm dope. Dope energy attracts, and that's true. So you feel like, you know, you have negative people around you, or you feel like a lot of negative energy, you're negative. But you feel you got a lot of dope people around you every now and then, some, you know, some bad vibes come about. But, you know, I just believe that the energy you put out is the energy you get back. You dig? Joke of the day. What do farmers give their wives when they marry? Hogs and kisses. Boo. Random fact of the day. There are 180,000 islands in... Oh, yeah. Bah, bah. Random fact today, there are 180,000 islands in Finland. That's one for about every 30 people in the country. Wow. I didn't know Finland had 180. I didn't know Finland even had hella islands, y'all. That shows you. I like to travel, but I do not know the history behind these places. Although, I mean, I know like the core history behind a lot of these places I want to go to, but I don't know like the deep history. Like, I would never know that Finland had 180,000 islands. I'm about to actually look that up right after this. I'll get done recording and chopping up with y'all. Journal entry idea. What is your favorite game to play and why? First thing that came to my head is Monopoly. I don't know, something about it. Something about with money and buying houses and buying land. Monopoly is actually the way to get wealthy on a deep level. Like, I know we look at it as a game, but if you actually use that game mindset in real life, we will all be wealthy. Wow, I should do that myself. But like, I keep telling everybody, you know, I'm saying on camera right now, y'all. So if anybody's ever from Cleveland, if anybody's not there from Cleveland, it's this place in Cleveland called East Cleveland. East Cleveland, you know, and once upon a time was a very well-respected city. A lot of millionaires stayed there. Now, unfortunately, you know, it's going through some hard times, right? And a lot of houses are abandoned, unfortunately. And a lot of, you know, just a lot of stuff is going on there. I really feel like one day, East Cleveland is going to be a big-time gold mine, you know what I mean? Because East Cleveland is right next to Cleveland Clinic and Case Western Reserve. So therefore, after East Cleveland crumbles up, guess who's going to buy all that land? Case Western Reserve, Cleveland Clinic, University Hospital. And guess who's going to own some of that land? This guy right here. I'm calling it right now, y'all. Y'all can bring this clip up in 20 years from now. I'm definitely going to have some land in East Cleveland. Not sure how much, but I just really feel like, you know, that's going to be a city that's going to get gentrified one day. I don't know when. It may happen 10 years from now, 20 years from now. It may happen 50 years from now. But I'm telling y'all right now on camera, East Cleveland, Ohio, I know it looks really rough right now, but later down the line, it's going to be a gold mine, y'all. But back to the question. But yeah, Monopoly. Monopoly is definitely a game I like. I like to, like, you know, buy stuff and kind of hustle. And I like that. I like that. Something about that, you know what I mean? Although I'm not an entrepreneur right now, like I've been telling from the get-go, I aspire to be one, you dig? But with that being said, my family, your brother about to go catch some Z's. Got to wake up in the morning. Work in the basement a little bit. And tomorrow, you know, I got some good shit coming tomorrow. I'm going to wait to talk to y'all about tomorrow, you dig? Peace, love, my family. See y'all tomorrow.